On the back of the news that a new documentary is in the pipeline about the bombing of the Grand Hotel in 1984, Bill Smith went down to the iconic building to look back on that terrible day and the events that led up to the tragedy.
At 2:54 a.m. on October the 12th, 1984, the Grand Hotel in Brighton was bombed by the Irish Republican Army.
Are you so holy? Have you got the right? Who is the judge? And who is your jury?
In a failed attempt to assassinate the then British Prime Minister, Margaret Thatcher, and the members of the Conservative government.
In front of them. It's only your
now, the team behind the hit TV show Peaky Blinders is set to produce a four-part TV series reimagining the IRA bomb attack according to the Jonathan Lee novel High Dive. Almost 35 years later, in a different world, yet more relevant than ever.
The 80s were a very divisive period in politics in Brighton and around the UK. And obviously we have the very same thing today, as you said, with the Irish backstop being a big issue now. It was a very divisive time, the 80s. The miners' strike was on. Margaret Thatcher was in power. There was an awful lot of fights, basically, real fights on the streets of Brighton as well as other places. I think history is always relevant, and the story of Irish independence, the Irish independence movement, is a great story, you know, and also a very important political issue then and now. I remember Brighton in those times. There was a movement in Brighton and across the UK in support of Irish independence and against the British Army being in Northern Ireland. It was called Troops Out. Many people in Brighton were in that movement. Many people who are well known in Brighton were in that movement. They might not want it known. But Troops Out was very much anti-Thatcher, very much anti what was happening with the British Army in Northern Ireland. And the same, and we don't have that problem anymore, if you like, in Ireland, where we have luckily now got peace, but we still have very divided communities in Ireland, especially in the north, and in Brighton too. I guess the period could be summed up, if you're looking at the sort of anti-Thatcher side, by the single, which was by the Angelic Upstarts, and was called The Brighton Bomb.